In this video, I will be covering SI units and prefixes, SI units. Having a basic understanding of SI units is extremely important for all the sciences. They are the standardized method of measurement, and there are 7 base SI units from which other measurements are derived. They are the meter, which is defined as the length of the path traveled by light in a vacuum during a time interval of 1/299,792,458 of a second. The kilogram, which is defined as anything equal to the mass of the international prototype of the kilogram. The second, which is defined as the time that elapses during 9,192,631,770 cycles of the radiation produced by the transition between two levels of the cesium-133 atom. And by now, you're definitely wondering, why in God's name are these definitions so weird? And the answer is, the units were derived before the definitions, and so scientists tried to find a constant in nature that equals the unit we created. Moving on, the Kelvin is the SI unit for temperature and can be converted to Celsius by subtracting 273.15 from the reading. This is because the Kelvin starts at a temperature lovingly named absolute zero, which is the lowest temperature theoretically possible, where the particles of a solid stop vibrating. The SI unit for electrical current is the ampere, or the amp, defined as that constant current which, if maintained in two straight parallel conductors of infinite length of negligible circular cross-section and placed 1 meter apart in a vacuum, would produce these conductors a force equal to 2×10⁻⁷ newtons per meter of length. And no, I don't know what that means. Next is the SI unit for luminous intensity, and that is the candela, which is defined as the luminous intensity in a given direction of a source that emits monochromatic radiation of a frequency of 540×10⁻¹² hertz and has a radiant intensity in that same direction of 1/683 watts per steradian unit solid angle. Finally, the SI unit for amount of stuff is the mole. The mole can be defined by whatever is written here, but more simply, a mole is just the number 6.02×10⁰³ power, literally. For example, a mole of ice cream would be 6.02×10⁰³ power ice creams. Next on the agenda is to cover SI unit prefixes, the bits that go in the beginning, starting with femto, which makes a unit 10⁻¹⁵ smaller, then the pico, which is 10⁻¹². Nano, which is 1 billion times smaller than the base unit. Micro, which is 1 million times smaller. Milli is 1,000 times smaller. Centi, 100, and deci, 10. Then, things start getting bigger. Deca makes things 10 times bigger. Hecto, 100 times. Kilo, 1,000 times. Mega makes things 1 million times bigger. But it doesn't stop there. We still have giga, tera, and peta. So those are all the prefixes you'll ever need in school, but there are prefixes for smaller and bigger things yet. Finally, those who are attentive may remember me mentioning that SI units are used to derive measurements, such as speed, which is distance divided by time, or density, which is derived from kilograms per cubic meter. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, be sure to click that like button, and bye-bye.